tonight on the table, representing not Cricks, but Khador, I'll fix that, is Bubba with his Vlad 2 list. Bubba, what do you have in your list?
So I have the Winter Guard Rifle Corps with Joe, max unit, mediocre mares, Ruin, Vlad 2, a Victor, back here is Silas, hiding behind the Victor is a Hounenholt, and advanced deploy a unit of two.
Okay, and what objective did you... Actually, what scenario are we running?
This is Fire Sport.
And what objective did you select?
I have Arcane 1.
Okay, and over to you, Alex. What do you have on the table?
All right, I've got Harbinger with the Hierophant, the Vows, Vanquisher, Reckoner, Avatar, Max Elves, Attachment, Covenant, Choir, two Vassals, a Vassal Mechanic, Rogue.
Excellent. And you, who won the roll?
Alex did.
Alex, and you chose to go, you chose side, correct? Okay, so I guess, Bubba, it's off to you to start off. And so as Bubba does, goes through his opening moves, just a reminder, this is a Challenge League game. These are rules that have been provided by Black Knight Games down in London, Ontario. This is a league we're running locally where we have, I think, about 15 of our local players battling for the number one spot.
Oh, I have to make a command check on my rifle
corps. No, Bubba's making a command check on his rifle corps because they're within 3 inches of Rune.
The rifle corps will run.
Rifle corps is running. Joe is knocked over, so following Canadian rules, he has to be removed from play. Alex is laughing, but he doesn't realize that it will affect him as well. This table seems to knock things over whether you want them to or not. So, the Challenge League. So, yes, we have 15 guys running this league where you have four tiers. Currently, the number one player is myself, through no lack of, through no skill or... Yes, as I say, I want to talk about me first. I've defended my number one position twice. But we have... So tier one is one person. Tier two contains three people.
Joe's going to advance.
Joe's advancing. And he's giving Tough and Fearless to his Rifleman Corps. Alex is actually part of the tier two level. He has gone up from... Did you start in tier four or did you start in tier three? Tier three. So you've made your... You're advanced into the second tier and you're defending that tier two position above it. So Bubba's casting a sail onto the Victor. And what does a sail do for people like me that don't know?
Plus 2 inches of movement when he charges or tramples, and it does it for free.
Okay, so plus 2 inches for a charge or trample, and does it for free. So the Tier 3 has four people, and the balance of the people are on Tier 5. We actually have two other games being played at a local store tonight. We have Mark, who is Tier 2, defending his tier against Rob, who's on Tier 3. Mark is playing Menoth Fiora, I believe. P. Fiora. And Rob is playing Doomy 3. An excellent choice, I may add, as a troll player and playing the same caster in this league. And we also have Corey taking on... Who's Corey playing against? Oh, Nathan. Nathan. So Corey is playing... You think I'd look this stuff up ahead of time. Do we know who Corey's playing?
What caster?
Yeah.
Vlad 3. He switched.
Oh, he switched to Vlad 3, which we actually...
So Vlad's going to turn like that. So. And he's going to cast Razor Wind at Ruin.
So Vlad is casting Razor Wind on Ruin.
I do... two damage.
Does two damage to Ruin. To the 5. So Corey is playing Vlad 3.
Vlad takes... one damage.
Vlad is taking one damage and is now plus one to all of his stats. So that would be...
And then I'll heal that one.
And then he's healing it back, giving him a bit of a boost for next turn. So Corey is playing Vlad 3 into Nathan's Thyron. Nathan is defending his tier 3 position to Corey, who's in tier 4. Rune has run up. The Mediocre Bears, which I'm sure have a real name that I'm not familiar with. The Great Bears, okay. And the Great Bears are fearless and not affected by Ruin. Iona and Holt are running up. The bridge terrain there is just doesn't count as a wall or a hill. It's just pretty to look at. Victor is going to trample. There's no charge due to the spell that Bubba cast earlier. Trying to position it so he does not clip his caster. Just positioning everything, making sure he's properly aligned, not hitting his own guys when going through. And then Silas is running in behind, just checking control. And that brings us back to Alex's turn. How much time do you have left on the clock? 51 minutes. So that was a 9.
Oh, I'm 2 minutes behind because we lost the clock.
Oh, that's right. Bubba was talking instead of looking at his clock.
No, Alex didn't pause it. He's a monster.
Roll for the avatar. 6!
First turn. That's what the avatar does.
6 for the avatar. So the avatar gets 6 focus. And just a reminder, this broadcast, that's the word I'm looking for, is brought to you by the Four New Gamers podcast. So if you hear me talking very basic things about the game, it's because I'm a new gamer and I have to explain this so I understand it. So it's more for me than anyone else. And we do have a live chat going on, so if you have any questions for the players, please feel free to put them in. Even if they're offensive, I will ask them.
13-14.
So Alex just asking about the Doom Reavers. Just clarifying that the Rifleman Corps are non-magic. We are up to 5 viewers, so please comment in the chat section. So Zealots are running and activating their mini feet. What's their mini feet, Alex? Okay, cannot take damage for either feats or spells. And cannot be targeted by enemy spells.
That's a separate.
Yeah. Oh, is that actually a regular ability?
They can do one every turn.
Okay.
The ability they can do every turn, which is either fervor, can't be targeted by spells.
Okay, yeah. So it's
once
that's
per game mini feet of can't take damage separate feats as well.
Okay.
So they can only damage by feats.
Okay. And they have their speed 6, so you can run them 12.
Yeah. Okay.
So we will be providing updates from the other Challenge League games as they go on, assuming someone messages me and tells me what's going on.
Whatever. I assume, unless they're charging, and if they're charging, something's going horribly wrong. Although, I did have them charging to fire your ears and take them up with receiver's call and stuff. Oh, fire your ears, extra armor. I'm like, oh, the charges are even better than throwing bombs.
Are they like how 8?
9?
Don't
no, 7. Like, yeah.
7-9. And for those who are only able to watch part of the game, this game will be uploaded to YouTube shortly after it's completed. You can follow us at Defhead Dice, DEFF Head Dice, on Twitch, Twitter, YouTube, Tumblr. I've got all the social medias covered. Oh, just to clarify, so the rolling of the 6 for the avatar gets them D3 plus 1, correct? It's not our step. That was me being mistaken, so you're correct.
First turn, he always rolls that.
Yeah.
He always rolls a 5 or 6.
So he has a... so right now he's sitting on 4 focus. Thank you for pointing that out. I'm not going to try to pronounce that name because I will do a horrible job. 87. So the Covenant are running now? Or the book, as it's often referred to as? Thank you for using the real name, because that's the only way I'll learn. And a side note, I don't like the Covenant. I ran into it at the OTC, and it made my life a miserable hell.
Sounds about right.
Especially with Rune Shapers.
Choir will activate.
Choir is activating and moving up just slightly. Looks like they're just sort of edging forward slightly. Dolus 87 is commenting that he's Greek. Are you from? Are you actually in Greece right now, or are you of Greek ancestry? Sorry, moving up another jack. I wasn't paying attention. Running the Vanquisher, thank you.
Okay, and then this vassal on the left is going to activate Supply and Conciliate.
So the vassal on the right is going to walk up 5.
And I'm going to Conciliate and I'm going to shoot this guy.
So he's going to Conciliate.
Def 1 Bajillion. Def 19. Engage on him.
So it's going to scatter because it was def 19.
Perfect.
Scatters.
Perfect.
Goes right back. So it's going to scatter back 3.5 inches. And so it sets them on fire. Yeah, they can't take any damage because of the mini feeds. And a new Purif. Okay. Well, thank you for joining us, Duelist 87. Must be late there if you're in Greece right now.
In Greece?
He's actually in Greece, yep. He got into War Machine in the last year. So what factions do you, or faction do you play? Right, moving up behind the wall.
And then you are in the post.
Yes, correct.
Just making it just a tick. Just check my mass control.
Yes, the mass, the Kashi is focus 10, so you have a 20-inch control area, which I think everyone would agree
right,
is disgusting.
Shoot him. Boost.
So he's going to shoot at the Doom Reaver in the forest. Needs a 10 on 3 dice. And misses. With a, looks like a 7 or a 6.
This vassal is going to activate. They're going
to
run.
Roven and Co. are running. For some reason, Barry just vomited a little. Maybe take some Pepto-Bismol or some...
Okay, this house is going to activate and come up slightly.
He's going to come up. The vassal is going to...
Okay.
And if the jack takes damage, he gets...
So you put it 11? Okay, so... So just cast or put enliven on the...
Yeah.
Okay. Okay.
Vassals are OP.
Vassals are OP according to Bubba, which automatically means it's probably true. So Bubba wants all the good things for Khador, so that's the reason why they can't have all the good things.
Spend to use during its activation.
was the question? And what does the gaze do?
It's probably not going to apply. I have to move directly towards.
Yeah. Okay, so anything.
Sorry, towards. Yeah.
Anything within that 8 inch has to move towards. Okay.
And at the start of their activation.
Yeah.
They have to move towards. And closer to him.
So even if it's like a nudge, you're still moving closer. That still qualifies. You're not. It's not a certain distance.
So like I can still charge other things, like late game. Like say late game. It's not going to matter now. But
yeah.
Late game, I can still do that. I charge the book because I end closer. Mm-hmm. That's all that matters. It's not direct.
Okay.
Harbinger's going to activate in advance. On the hill.
So Harbinger is popping her feet, which means anyone moving towards her into her control area takes a POW 14
fire damage roll.
You'll see the gorgeously painted feet token on the table there. That's a Musa mini token, that wooden token that Alex painted. It looks very nice. Yes, they are fantastic.
The device will activate and advance 5 inches.
As Bubba's bringing it a little bit of a glare. There we go. Camera does not do it justice. And we've been ignoring all the stuff that Alex has been doing. So spell barrier has just been cast. And he's moving the mechanic up to fill in the gap.
Alright, to you, sir.
It's back to Bubba. How much time do you have left on the clock?
46.
46 minutes. We're starting the top of two. Inverted axis comments. Axes comments. Come on, come in, Alex. I don't know where you're out. Team last spot is behind you. I guess that was kind of mean of me to point out the typo, but hey. Grammar matters. So I'm just going to check and see if we have any updates from our other matches going on. No, we have not. That is the update. No updates from the other games. So if Alex... Actually, I won't spoil that yet. We'll wait till the game gets close to the end. Where it really comes down to.
Joe's gonna go. He's gonna stand right there, give him tough and fearless.
So Bubba is activating Joe and giving him tough and fearless.
Rifle core run well.
He's thinking about the rifle core. We are up to 6 live viewers.
Doomreavers gonna go, they're gonna run.
Okay. So Doom Reavers are running? They have Pathfinder?
They do not. That's why he's slow.
Okay.
He's going to run.
The question is, so the only targets for Vlad's feet are the Doom Reavers? I'm not sure if that's a...
That's not true. You can make
them higher at. You can give the Rifleman Corps.
Up to Rat 8.
Rat 8,
that's
yeah.
Speed 4, correct? So good. Threat's 10. We'll see threat 10. Threat's 8.5. Very, very sweet. You have passed over your deck?
Yeah.
Can't target on a match shooting?
Yeah.
So I'll turn down the volume a little bit on the background mic because my furnace is about to kick in. There's a reason why we do call this the furnace room.
Oh, I don't have to pay for a sale. It's free from Silas. That's right.
So you...
Here, I'll just give the victor one instead.
So you...
The glass is still on.
So Bubba gave a sale to the victor, free of charge through a Silas. There's stuff going on, and I haven't been paying attention.
Good. I don't want you to pay attention.
That way the internet can't catch you on whatever you've done.
Ruin's going to run.
So Ruin is running.
Or skirting the water.
Just skirting the water. Control. And checking control.
Another two.
Moving up another two. Oh, Vlad is dead. Game over. Good game. Do we know the origin of the Canadian rule for knocking over a model? Bubba. Whenever in doubt, it's Bubba's fault.
Yeah, I'm not
done. Okay. Alex, is Jones going to roll that PAL 14? So 1 point to the one on Ruin for Harby's feet. Something easily or Ruin can easily take. Ian and Holt are thinking about something. This is a conversation talking about... Sorry, what was going on?
Magic weapons.
Oh, giving magic weapons to Victor? Because, you know, he's not disgusting enough as it is. So Victor is going to, looks like he's just walking up.
Just
trying not, just towing the back of the hill. Now, does he get a benefit from being a colossal for being on the
sees
hill?
Sees over everything.
Sees over, so he doesn't get a defense bonus, but he does be able to see over thing. Would he not it normally because of the huge size base?
Take a scythe, I guess, before he rolls. It'll be on the right side. Right.
Okay, and... So dice off 6, so 5 damage to the 2 on the right side from Harbinger's feet. And he has how many boxes? It's 60 boxes?
62.
Because 60 wasn't just enough. Who has the most?
Hyperion.
He is going to shoot at Harby. So Harby... Needed boxcars, got an 11.
Red's direction.
So 3 inches to the 5.
That's pretty good. Totally pulled out.
3 inches to the 5 puts it just a little bit to the left. So it looks like it's hitting 4 models. So they're just remeasuring it to make sure they got the right angle.
It's a 5-inch area.
Yeah, so that was a pretty good placed, although intentional, unintentional, a good scatter.
Sign of a good player.
Yep, so that's a POW...
it's only POW 8.
POW 8 damage, so... Okay. And they're all on fire now?
Yep.
Burn, baby, burn. Victor Inferno. Burn, baby, burn.
She's at 14 plus 4, so... 18.
So 18, so...
And the vassal's at armor 14. I'll just roll damage on the avatar.
Just doing it on the avatar?
Nothing.
Nothing?
I'll roll damage on the other jack.
On the other jack?
I'll roll damage on Roven & Co. So R16. Yep.
For Roven & Co. Off dice off 8, so 12, damage. So 4 damage.
I'll roll damage on the book. Nothing.
Nothing on the book?
Is he armor 12, 6 points. But I think he's armor 12. Right? Oh, 6 points.
So one, actually, 1 point of damage to the book. 4 to go. Bubba's trying to figure out who he wants to boost on, whether Vassal or Harvey. Boosting on Vassal. Takes the Vassal.
Yep.
So doing a martyr roll.
Boom.
Three to Harvey.
Nothing.
Nothing on Harvey with a roll of a three. Does martyr have any effect like a tough roll where you're knocked down, or?
You tough. So if you had tough, you tough first,
yep.
Then you martyr.
Okay, but the martyr doesn't, if you're not knocked down, martyr doesn't force you to be knocked down. Okay, I just wasn't sure if it was the same mechanic or different, so. A victor. Yes, it is very much a victor. As the model's not out yet, Bubba's proxying it, so it does look like a conquest, but it's actually a victor. Bubba's moving Vlad. Think about what he wants to do with him. He's keeping him within, looks like, with an inch of the victor. He's camping five from the looks of it. No. Checking control, not in there. Okay, so he's just going to sit there and camp. So Bubba's activating the Great Bears. They're moving out of the feet range to avoid that POW 14. Keeping one just towing in the forest. Rifle Corps running. They're all, from the looks of it, moving out of away from Harvey, therefore avoiding the feet. Just clarifying the blast on the. I'd like to say I remember the guys in the front, but I don't remember. Again, I was just placing strategically, so if there are some AoEs coming in at them, they're not going to take out multiples. And that's the end of his turn. Bubba, what time are you at? 40 minutes, so this is bottom of two. Alex is just removing his spells, and then we'll be doing the fire checks on those four units.
Okay, starting on Avatar.
Avatar? Dice off nine, so.
This guy. It went out. Sorry. Vanquisher,
fire goes out.
Covenant.
And the Covenant does not go out. So book is down to, our Covenant is down to three, I believe.
Okay, Vassal.
Keeps going. Martyrs and 1 point of damage to Harvey. What's Harvey at right now?
13.
Come on,
okay.
Don't go up. Harvey.
Oh, Harvey goes out.
I would roll out.
Key move. Key for Alex's turn. As we all know, fire damage is a bitch.
One to the devout.
So giving one to the devout. And it looks like he's keeping the remaining nine for Harvey.
Nine. Avatar generates probably six.
Three plus one. So Avatar just rolled a four, so it's D3 plus one, so he's up to four again. That's right, three. My bad. Math is hard.
Okay. Those are all the effects.
All the effects are taken care of. For more excitement like this, you can check our YouTube channel where we've got all our past Home Machine games.
All
No, we got the 2015 editions where there were more games with me playing my son, where we break rules with wild abandon.
There wasn't a lot of Home Machine games, was there?
Well, there was like, we did 11 last year.
Oh, you're going to do like weekends.
Hopefully. Do a couple weekend back-to-back games.
Yeah.
Do a few back-to-back games. I'd like to see if we can get a couple games going at the same time and switch back and forth. A couple live games. I'm hoping to get a be able to stream our charity event as well. I just have to talk to Rogers and see if I can get a USB key from them. One of the wireless keys as a donation. Well, for those in the Kitchener-Waterloo area, we're going to be having a charity event on May 21st, Saturday. Using the Home Machine rules as a fundraiser for cystic fibrosis. I'll put notes in the YouTube section or the comment section if you want to check that out.
All right, choir will activate.
So Alex is activating the choir and advancing. Wasn't sure if he can move through. It looks like his. Just checking to see if he can make it through. Too close, so he's deciding not to move. So. That's the choir you're moving up, correct? Okay. So he's putting passage on the three jacks.
He just doesn't make a check. Okay. Fire has to be
okay. And what is passage do?
Can't be shot by non-magical.
Can't but not be shot by non-magical. Now, if you shoot it, does it automatically miss and scatter if it's a blast?
It's target or automatically miss.
So that way you wouldn't be able to choose it as a target and miss. Okay.
Okay.
Okay,
against
Menoth, so well. Which is a dirty lot because I played against Menoth twice in the OTC.
Yeah.
Alright, the Rector is going to activate, he's going to stand still.
Rector is activating, staying still, and shooting at that one Doom Reaver. Apparently, that Doom Reaver has ticked him off somehow and feels that he has to be eliminated. Not true.
That sounds stupid. You still get an aiming points. Yeah, so
this is six. Six on two dice. Managed to get that, and that Doom Reaver is dead.
Okay.
That was part of the Spencer collection, which is also part of the Less collection on loan. And so, who was that you're moving up?
Basil.
The Basil. Enlivening again.
Okay. Zealots are going to activate. Chopping.
Zealots are actually chopping. Activating and walking. A bomb and reach. So A bomb, of course, is abomination. If these models move within their melee range, they have to take a command check. Yes. Good thing you asked before doing. Alex was just confirming that you can't check his melee range while he's moving, or his opponent's melee range. I guess is what he'd be looking at, wouldn't he not? So just moving a few of these guys up.
So
we're up to 9. We're almost at double digits. So if you're watching this, message your friends. Tell them to watch it as well.
Tell your wives, tell your kids.
Yes.
And Tara from your reach
range.
And let us know if you're watching this on a large screen television, because we feel so much more satisfied knowing this is on a large screen. Not just on a phone or a tablet. So he's ending the movement facing the Doom Reaver?
Yeah.
So this is our second Tuesday game. We're trying to keep this going on a weekly basis. If you have any input on who you want to see play next or what faction, let us know. Between the group we have here, we can field just about anything that we want.
Literally, I think. except pigs.
Yeah, no pigs.
So you play gators.
Yep.
You play,
Scorn. Gators, Scorn. Yeah, pretty much anything. So if you want to see something played, let us know.
Other than Khador, apparently,
because Khador run like every week. Yeah, Khador and trolls. Although it was a troll free, it's been two troll free weeks. I'm a little confused.
Next week.
Yep.
Showdown.
Yep. Take on Mark.
Good.
Fiora. Mark, of course, is the host of the combo smite. Oh, abomination check for.
A bomb's three.
Oh, A bomb is 3 inches, not
okay.
Melee.
I thought it was...
So, command check makes it. Command check for rune. Ooh. So
okay.
Moved a little bit too close. So they are now, what's the term when they're is it fleeing? Is it fleeing? Okay. I always have to confuse my old 40k terminology with War Machine on occasion. Apparently, people didn't like what I was saying because we're now down to our 8 viewers. Bubba, you're offending people.
I didn't do anything.
Exactly.
I made zealots scared.
Yeah. You scared the zealots. Yes, that means it buys you another little bit of time. Pitcher received in our group. Let us see. Oh, there we go. Phil is watching this on the large screen. Thank you, Phil. I appreciate that.
I did that the first time, too.
Did you?
55-inch TV. I was like, I'm throwing up the game.
That is fantastic. So thank you, Phil.
That is the way to do it.
I was going to say, it makes. I would prefer to do that if I had actually had a big screen TV. So.
4 inches.
So he's advancing the jack 4 inches. And he's shooting the Doom Reaver behind the hill. Oh, he's just tagging on the hill. So he needs a 10 to hit. And misses. Scatters 5 inches. As I say, you got to measure the distance there. 7.5 inches, so he's going to scatter 3 and a bit. And looks like it's going to tag Ruin in the one zealot. Yeah, goes half. Can't hurt the... Yep, kills his own zealot.
Is it enemy attack? If it is. I'm pretty sure it's enemy attack.
Now, could he martyr that if he wanted?
No, because it has to be within his command. And he also has to...
By enemy attack, yes.
And I think he has to martyr enemy. Oh, no, it's modeled.
Okay.
So he doesn't get as many feet. He has
okay.
Or not many feet.
Martyr.
No, it's not even battle damage.
No, it's
better.
Just a part of their... It's just
when they're hurt, they get +4 armor.
Yeah. Okay, but Harvey couldn't martyr him if he wanted to.
No, she's not.
Oh, not his command. Okay.
The Robin is going to activate. I'm going to charge the steel reaver.
Yeah,
I'm going to charge 6, 9 reach.
Yes, I mean the what the
their
that that's the one Wayne has. So Rovan is staying behind the wall. Doesn't want to get out into the fray.
This guy's gonna run.
This guy being
the other bodyguard.
The other
bodyguard. It's Rovan and two bodyguards.
Okay.
And they're a boss. They're like great bears.
Best we have.
Cool. Okay, so each of them separate rules.
No, the bodyguard's the same. Rovan has special rules.
Okay.
But they're like.
He gets him on a 5.
Or 14 weapon master.
Yeah, POW 14 weapon master. Yeah, it's a...
Great
battle. Yeah.
Okay. My book will activate in advance.
I'm sure that sounds great on the microphone. Even bigger.
Advance 5 inches.
For those just tuning in, I'm just finishing off my supper.
If you said Power Bait, no one on stream would know what that thing is. I'll be like, that's no knockdown,
that's how
right?
It is. That's no knockdown. That's actually, it's
okay.
The lawgiver's creed. It's the lawgiver's creed.
Yeah, see?
Thank you for asking, Mary. I made homemade burgers with sautéed onions and mushrooms, bacon, and a little bit of Havarti cheese on a Costco ciabatta bun. And yes, it was delicious. Hey, Fraser, did Alex roll for that command check? Which command check, Phil? Of course, hand-rolled patties. You cannot buy. Frozen burgers are a sin against the palate. No, I smush. I'm a smusher, not a roller. A little bit of the Montreal steak spice mixed in. Oh, it's slice of heaven. Yep. Yeah, that's all you need. Good burgers, just a couple of good dashes of that, and you're good to go. I like you too, Barry.
It's Cameron, but you know.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yes.
So I probably should pay attention to the game, so he's checking to see if checking the Doom Reaver to see if he's in line of sight. From this angle, it looks good.
That's why I think it's
yep, so he looks confirmed that he is. So he's within the arc. Gaze range or arc. And that's just a standard ability. He does not, is that an act, something
he
has
to spend a focus.
So it does cost a focus, okay.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. So one of the benefits of having people come here and play is I actually have to pay attention to all your games and tell people what's going on, so I'm being forced to learn the rules. I recommend it for anyone interested.
I like forcing Harvey to purify.
And how much does purify cost?
Well,
okay.
Two is a copy of that.
That's a big one. Because
you took like... No,
it only took four.
Oh, you mean Marv again. Yeah.
This vassal.
So we need to keep that vassal alive.
Yep.
Because vassals are excellent. Basically, Harvey's taken like 6 points of damage.
Yeah.
Keep it
2 points old. Interesting. So Bubba's just commenting, in case it didn't get picked up on Mikey's sheet, Harvey has spent six boxes to keep a 2 point solo alive. Going to enliven the avatar. Activating Harbinger. Take that back. So what's the choirs in the way of? That's what's.
Yeah, I just screwed up the choirs. She's just going straightforward, face to face to heal, and then I can walk
right. Okay.
Because there's no way I can.
Clearly, the vassal can.
The vassal
that's actually legitimate plan.
So Bubba's proposed that the vassal mechanic could go in and kill the one choir to give him the room to move the other model up to heal Harvey. But whether or not this is the move he wants to make.
Alright, let's charge my vassal.
So so the vassal is going to charge into the choir. Staying just within the range of the melee range.
Alright, what are you, vassal? Like,
who knows?
The vassal.
First time the vassal's ever attacked.
Apparently this is a
Matt
unique... Matt 5, 7 on the back.
And they're 13
12, so needs 5 on 2 dice. Gets it on a 6. Gonna martyr that? So now he's getting back to the original plan.
All this, you're gonna roll. Now, if you roll so, 6, you're gonna look like an internet genius.
Yeah, so this, here's.
Right. Healing.
So he's gonna heal. D3, or is it D6?
D6.
So right, 2 D6. Points.
No,
D3.
Yeah.
D6. So hailing 1 point.
Hailing 1 point. So it was worth it. It was totally worth it.
But it made for dramaticness. Dramaticness? A dramatic moment in this game.
Alright, Devote's going to activate one. Around
the hey, we're back up to 9. Someone came back from the washroom.
And spend my 1 to get back on the race. Spellbearer?
Yep.
So he's moving up the jack and putting on Spellbearer.
Alright, Harbinger's going to activate. I need to get a...
So Harvey is going to... Looks like he's going to have to purify.
Harvey takes 5.
Yes. Harvey is not a fan of fire. Being a troll player with pyre trolls and fire eaters, I don't understand that concept.
So I'll stand still, purify, because...
She's purifying the fire away. Only because she has to.
She's not a fire sword. And...
Apparently, Haley is a Bon Jovi fan. Because she was living on the edge. I'm hoping that moan from Alex was to my joke, because it'll just make me feel better about it. And he's spending 2 to heal.
So what she said? 1 box. So you need to use
that.
It's
the better
fire.
Yeah.
Same
with 1 box. Yeah, especially
you
go going up and down. Yeah. No, I completely agree.
Or even we can have the card. It's just easy to take the dial and just be like, ooh.
Yeah, agreed. Okay, just commenting about the Musa mini dial where it goes up to 20 where you can have keep track of your damage, sure. Especially on casters that go up and down like Mirvana 2 or Harvey as well. Okay. Turn is back over to Bubba. How much time do you have left on your 26 clock?
Minutes.
26 minutes. And we're now in the top of 3. Bubba's at, I believe, 40 minutes. Not sure what Barry is arguing, but I'm sure eventually this will catch up and he'll let me know what he's arguing. For those in the chat or in the watching, let us know how you found out about this game. Was it through Bubba harassing you, me harassing you, or through the social medias?
So I'll let people sail for free.
So Bubba is keeping a sail for free. And he's giving the Victor 2 focus and staying 3. Fire on. Fire stays on Victor.
Dice off 8.
Takes so the Victor takes 3 to the 5 from the fire damage. So it's 3 to the right because apparently it's dealer's choice.
It is. Okay. Last to go.
Vlad is activating. He's going to defeat. Bubba's putting down his fancy coin.
D3 plus 3 models. 4.
Oh, so some gamers. People saw in the 4 new gamers pace. That's good.
The 4 doom rivers are super soldiers.
Sorry, I wasn't paying attention, so.
The 4 doom rivers. I feed it, roll a 1.
Okay.
Roll.
Okay. Are super soldiers, so they're just going to kill the world.
He's going to cast Hand of Fate for 1 because of my objective on the rifle corps.
So he's casting Hand of Fate for 1 on the rifle corps because of his objective.
As far back as I can be.
I was just checking to see where he can leave Vlad, where he's the least vulnerable. It's still staying in the kill box, because this is a kill box scenario. What did Alex roll for the command checks on the Zealots? 11, I believe, originally. Yeah, it was 11. It was a 5 and a 6. Yeah, it was not good.
So that's flat.
And that was actually a question from Phil Bo Baggins, one of the co-hosts of the Forty Gamer podcast.
Most.
The proud sponsors of this series of streamed War Machine games. Be sure to check them out. Their next episode is due as soon as I'm done editing it. And we talk about our adventures at the OTC.
Joe's
going to go. So Bubba's activating Joe.
He's moving 3 through the forest. Boosted attack rolls.
Boosted attack rolls.
He's going to shoot.
And now he's going to shoot at a zealot. Oh, he's wondering if that was the right move. Oh, he's moving up a slightly different position. He is going to shoot at nothing because he's short from the target he picked.
That's, he dies, they don't get the plus 4 armor. Yeah.
And that's the UA for the Zealots. Yes, he was targeting the UA there. Wasn't quite within range.
You didn't try to rally him in any turn.
Now, someone said, you mean the Zealots that are fearless when the bearer is there?
Are they fearless?
That's refugee. Okay, so they correct. So they were fearless. So that would have made the last turn significantly different. Thank you for pointing that out. Bubba's offering to let him have that move.
Sure. Well, yeah, because it would, like, these guys would need to change this. Okay.
So Bubba's offering, but Alex is kindly turning it down. So Bob's activating the rifle core.
Still.
I think I've been in a couple of cases like that. The only way you learn is by getting beaten the crap out of you.
I thought they were like the one thing that wasn't fearless enough. Marc-Andre, he's just going to move up 3.
Better that we know.
It is.
Would have been nice a little bit sooner, but better that we know.
2, so he's got 4 left.
Up the rifle core? Riffle core. Riffle. Ruffles. Hey, we've hit 10! 10 people are watching this stream. Okay. I'm assuming the last one to enter would be Marc-Andre LeBlanc. Thank you for joining us. If there was a way to Skype this call at the same time, I would have you help me commentate because you know the rules better than I do.
So no one aimed.
Yep. So no one aimed? Because they all moved. But
4 dice to hit. Yeah.
They need what sort of hit?
They get 4 dice to hit.
Oh, 4 dice to hit.
So.
Now, is it minus 1 after the 4? Or is it? Yeah, okay.
This guy's going to shoot there. Yep. So,
def 12 against the Zealots.
I need
7s. 7s to hit.
Yep.
Yeah, that one hits. Okay.
Now they're arm 16. Yeah, I
realize
this should be a model first. Those two.
Arm 16.
Yeah.
Going to the Monolith Bear now.
Hits.
That hits.
Or no, he's armor 16.
He's armor 16.
So he takes 2 boxes.
Oh, the Monolith Bear is down to. How many boxes does he have?
He's 5.
5, so he's down to 3 boxes.
This guy from downtown?
So that one, just on the edge of the forest, is going to hit.
7 hits.
7. Barely gets it.
1 point.
1 more point to the Monolith Bear. So he's down to 2 boxes. So he's going to try again.
Ooh,
that one does hit, yep. No damage on that roll. Again on the monolith. Oh, that one's significant hit. Gonna martyr that one. Takes so Harvey takes 3 points of damage to keep that monolith bearer in play. Harvey is down to 13. So Cameron had to leave the game, but he's wishing both you gentlemen good luck. Way to sit in the middle of the fence there, Cameron. And Bubba is continuing to pick away at the zealots here. And another one. Oh, not martyring this time. He's not willing to.
Are they still half plus warmer? They're still. Right? No more.
Yeah.
They still have. This one's going to shoot fast.
Well, taking a shot at Vassal.
I think it's just cross.
Yeah. Kane's plus one for one.
Yeah, for one. This guy's going to shoot
Vassal. Yep, that's 10.
10. Martyr.
Martyring for
three.
So Harvey's down to 10. So Harvey is sitting at 10 boxes.
you
can martyr down. Significantly, when I was playing the game, I played against the at the OTC. The person had martyred down to one.
I play fast and loose tournaments, so.
Okay.
Fast and bone ripping.
So Doom Reavers are activating. So one of the funniest comments about this game was it was going to be the battle of the shoulder pads, since they both seem to have significant.
So he's going to charge the Romanico member.
Yeah.
The assessments, right?
So Doom Reavers are going to charge. Bubba's just trying to figure out who the charge targets are going to be. They're going after the zealots.
Yeah, they're gazed.
Bob is just making sure that he doesn't move so far that he gets the other ones out of line of sight.
Yep. You don't want to come past me,
so Alex is trying to figure out the super secret tech, and all Bubba wants to do is kill him. So next two Reavers, I'm going to charge the zealot.
So I don't know how what I'm speaking.
Sure, he's not in reach of his own guy.
He is going to charge.
Yep. Charging the zealot. Just making sure he isn't going past the guard there. Oh, back down to 8. And the last remaining... Is that the last Doom Reaver? He's just going to run.
4, 8.
9 inches. He's got 3 inches remaining.
No,
he's speed 9.
Oh, he's speed 9? He can run 18. He can
run another 9. Wow, that's ridiculous. Are they base speed 9, or is it because
my feet.
Plus 3 speed. Okay. And he's just going just to the edge. So in his melee or just out of his melee?
Just
into his melee range.
A bomb check
on the choir. That's abomination check. I should start using the written names.
Okay. So charge attack there.
Charge attack on the zealot.
Matt's attack. Hits. Blows him up.
He is gone.
So it should be an engine.
So he gets to attack again.
6 hits.
16
total. He's not
battle
driven right now. So
dice off
3. He
dead. Yep, and the guard is dead.
Everyone. Okay.
So Bubba was sure not to keep any of his guys within reach of their own, so they don't hits anyone else.
Hits dice off. He's 18 now.
Yeah.
So
So dice off five.
Dice off five, so that's five.
Berserk into him.
Berserking into the zealot. Takes him out.
Charge target is dead.
Yes, because zealots are doing command check. They're loving it. So Bubba's looking to activate rune. He's been sort of sitting back and enjoying the view for the last couple turns.
Rune's just going to walk.
Rune is walking. Speed 5, I'm assuming. Speed 4, that's right. So he's making sure he's within half inch of the zealot to his right, and he's actually going to base with the zealot on the right and stay. But he does want reach on the other zealot, so he's got, looks like he's got
so
zealots fist attack on the base to base. Rune does get a soul for that one. The soul train's about to begin. Using the soul to buy
second initial
on the other zealot.
Gets another soul.
Gets a second soul. So we'd use a soul to
buy a soul on him.
Buying attack with the soul. Gets
soul.
Another soul.
Buy a soul.
Buying another attack with a soul on the book. Book takes a point. Should be down to one, I believe. See, okay, he's down to two.
So second soul.
Second soul. Takes a point. Buying attack. So the book is gone. Good riddance is my personal opinion of the book, but that's, I'm only slightly biased.
He's not in line.
Rune has an abomination check. Rune has abomination, correct? Yes.
They would have had, the zealots would have had to take aim
on. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So yes, Rune does have abomination.
Yes, he does.
To answer that question. Wow, you sure it's not past your time, your bedtime, Dolus, 87? I mean, what time is it in Greece right now? It's what, like 6 hours
plus
difference?
Six. I think it's Central European. Well, plus daylight savings time.
Yeah, because that's only a couple. Doesn't matter, apparently.
Sorry. Plus daylight savings time.
I don't guess. We could Google it if we wanted an answer.
I don't know what
but...
time zone Greece is. Victor's going
to charge. So Victor is going to charge, what, sorry? The Vanquisher. Poor little Vanquisher. Bob was just putting a proxy base down to make sure he's got the lane. So he charges for free. He's going to move him in so he's not sitting on models or bumping models too badly. 2:14 in the morning.
Nice. I like his commitment.
There we go. Yes. Thank you very much for sticking with us. If you need a note for your boss tomorrow morning, let me know.
Six will hit.
So I needed a six to hit. Pow 22.
He's only
18. Only armor 18, so it's dice plus 4. No, dice plus 3.
It's a 12 on the dice, so 15 to the 5. Or 15 to the 3.
15 to the 3.
Second initial.
Hits on a... A solid 11.
Dice plus 3. 14.
14 to the 4.
Yes. 3 boxes.
3 boxes left.
Miss.
And he misses the next attack. Buys another attack.
Hits
on a 4. So good thing you put that extra focus on there. Or
apparently. I should have just used it.
Yeah.
Plan.
And Bubba called it before with only one focus on the avatar.
Mediocre.
So the avatar only has one focus on it right now. That's
no,
it.
No. Oh. He has to roll to start.
Okay, so he will only get. Okay, we're predicting it. We're calling it now.
Yeah.
So the great bears are moving up. They're just running. Now, is it if you start your movement within the gaze range of the avatar that you have to move, or is once you enter the range when you start? Okay. Thank you.
The jacks were fine. the Jimmy Rivers had to go closer, which they all did. He was out of gaze.
So you don't need a, so you are your own boss. Okay, got you. Well, give yourself permission to sleep in tomorrow morning. So Bubba's contemplating who to activate next. I believe the only ones left are Ivana and Holt, right? And Silas. So I was hoping to have more updates from the other games that are going on, but apparently that was too much to ask.
Holt's gonna shoot the outside. Oh, I can't. Holt gets magic weapons from Ayana.
So Holt is being given magic weapons by Ayana, and he's going to hit the avatar.
Dice off nine.
Nothing. Nothing. A nice flurry of activity, but without actually anything happening. Silas is activating, and just run up through the relative safety of the. Bubba is now at the end of middle of turn three at 22 minutes. Alex is at 26 minutes. We're just starting his turn, so he's getting back his focus. When do you roll for the avatar? Okay.
He can roll before, you generally roll before you allocate.
Okay.
Because they're like, oh, the avatar rolled four, I don't need to give the
other. Oh, you can still allocate to the avatar as well?
No, you can't, but it determines what you allocate to other people.
Oh, okay, gotcha. So, this avatar roll?
Called it.
Oh, one to the, so two, so it's D3 plus one, so two to the avatar.
So that's the great and horrible thing about the avatar.
Yeah. So the avatar will go strong in the first few turns and then completely tank in the last few.
There are turns where you're like, if he rolls four, that'd be cool.
Yeah.
And then he does. And you're like, sweet, he's gonna get a lot of work done.
Yeah.
And then all, like, every time it seems, it's like, he needs to do a lot of damage to this thing.
Yeah.
It's like,
son of a. Dag nabbit. So Bubba, our friend in Greece was saying, he said he plays Vlad2 and he saw your list. He thought, not a good list. And apparently I was wrong. So now I have to see how he pulls it off. So you've got a cheering section in Greece.
That was for your regular list. I was like, bastards, let's be set on fire. And I was like, come some up. Play like five on fire and be like, oh, that dice off four, make five fire checks. This, it's gonna get to this too, though. Because he got his threats here, so. In general, it's not a great Vlad2 list.
Okay.
But it's still actually really solid. Like,
well, and that's part of this challenge league, is the only requirement is to stay, keep the same caster. So we're allowed to tech towards the caster. We know what caster we're going up against. But not the list.
Both of us have changed our lists. Yep. Significantly.
All
right.
Yeah.
So,
which is another thing people do. It's like, I'm going to tech for what I saw you play last time, and then the guy changes, and you're like, damn it.
Yeah.
Rovan's going to activate his Tomahawk.
Absolutely.
Rovan's going to activate and then swing at, I believe, the Doom Reaver. Because I can't see behind the model.
Death 16.
So he kills the Doom Reaver?
That's all it was. Yeah. He's only under 17. It was the hitting. It was.
Who else is playing? Well, Phil, if you joined the game at the beginning when I called all this out, you would know who else was playing. Currently, according to our last schedule, Mark, our second tier person, is one of the three people on tier three, is playing, is taking a challenge from Rob on tier three, which is P Fiora versus Doomy 3, as well as Corey is challenging Nathan, Corey on tier four and Nathan on tier three, which is Vlad 3 versus Thyron. So those games may determine who I play next. I'm just hoping someone plays me before I have to play Bubba.
You don't want their passage?
Okay.
Passage.
I don't want to play Phil.
I don't want to play Phil.
Okay.
All right, I had a point
once. Okay. Bubba doesn't want to play
Battle
Phil.
Time.
Battle time. So,
he's there to take it when you
I roll. Oh my god! Like the first time, I actually wanted to miss, and he like rolled that 11. I was like, maybe just shit guards it. It's like, damn it. Like, I guess it's a huge hit out. You're out, which is cool.
So my bad. What are we doing right now?
He battled the two important jacks.
Oh, he battled the two important jacks. And
right,
who?
Avatar will go first, and I'm going to walk and stick on here. Okay.
So the Avatar is going to walk up and start pounding on the victor. Basically, non.
So that'll be POW 21 and POW 16.
So POW 21 on the first hit.
Hits.
Yep. Hits. Anything but
one.
Snake eyes.
One,
nine to the
four
on the left.
Second
initial. So it hits. POW 15 is off five. One to the five. Six to the four. Spying again. So
it's,
hits.
It rolls a bit,
but yeah.
Seven to the two. He has 31 boxes.
Ooh.
So I need 4 focuses.
Yeah, as I say, 4 focuses really would have helped.
This vessel, well, like that's what he did with the Avatar.
Yeah, it's almost all the other side's completely.
That's
well,
what he did with the two.
Okay.
Okay,
so you're less than half yet? Or
exactly half.
You're exactly half. Okay. So there's a question from our friend in Greece. He wants some input on his Vlad 2 list, but we'll wait till after the game to go through that. I just don't want to disturb Alex's.
I'm just mean, I guess.
Yeah. You're not the hostess with the mostess.
Walk 5 inches over the wall.
Well, you're not really a hostess either. I guess I should clarify that.
Okay. I'm going to make the initial attack. And then I'm going to
just
hit. Need
air
block, not
8. Yeah.
So 8's
hits.
To hit.
Close them up.
Again,
just roll on them eights.
So he takes out the other Doom Reaver. Now, does that wipe out all the Doom Reavers? There's
yeah.
one just hiding in behind where I can't see it.
Okay, this boss is going to advance.
So the vassal is enlivening. Who's the enliven? Who's the target for the enliven? The Reckoner. Okay.
Okay, gonna heal on base to base.
Healing when base to base.
2 points. So you're back up to 12. Yeah.
So Harbinger is back up to 12 points.
The devout should be base to base.
Yeah,
spell, of course. So spell barrier, on base to base, and then walking away. Because I attacked your 5 inches.
Harbinger's activating and running behind the wall.
She's gonna wait for Ruin.
Yip.
Ruin just
checking to make sure he's still within the kill box. Our high quality rosewood fence.
Over. That's it for Harbinger. And the mechanic is going to come over and run up to get the AB.
So he's running the mechanic up into base to base.
He gets some extra armor while he's there. Oh, he's got Iron Sentinel.
Yeah. With Iron Sentinel gives him extra armor.
And def. Plus 2 def.
And def. Well, plus 2 def as well.
Okay,
so clock is back, turn is back to Bubba, top of 4.
16:12 for Alex,
16 minutes and 12 seconds on Alex's clock, 22 minutes on Bubba's.
Gonna drop a sail, upkeep hand of feet for free.
Bubba's dropping a sail and upkeeping hands
right?
of feet for free. So he's putting 2 to the victor. Giving pause to figure where he's going to put the rest. Did you put the other on something else?
All right.
Oh, no, you still got 3. Okay, that's right.
I have 5 still.
Yeah. So does the victor generate its own fury or focus?
No.
Okay, then why is there 2 focus on the...
I gave it 2 already.
Okay.
I gave 2 to Ruin.
Oh, does he have 6?
He's 7.
Oh, 7, okay.
Kind of
okay, got it. Thank you. I was a little lost for a moment, so.
Yep.
So Joe is activating.
Boosted attack rolls.
Boosted attack rolls on the winter guard. Another dead model. Canadian rules. Bubba's measuring range. He's just in range.
Yeah.
So boosted.
Power
12. So he's got to martyr this. Oh, 6.
So 3. All right. He's rolled 3 on his martyrs, I think, 4 times.
So.
That's what Harbinger does.
Yeah. So Harby's down to
9 boxes.
Rifle Corps is going to activate. That's the Rifle Corps. I have to stop using Bubba's slang. So, he's going to start picking some targets. Vassal is going to be the target. That's a hit on a 13. No more martyr, so the Vassal is now gone. So now they're going to target the choir. Just within range. Takes out that choir member, places it the unit leader. Bubba's just tracking which guys have fired. So Bubba's targeting the Hierophant on the hill. That sounds like a 60s psychedelic song. 10 on 3 dice, that's a solid 14. Yeah.
Pow 10.
And there we go. Shooting the other choir member.
Hits.
That's a solid hit, and that would be it. Doing the unit or leader replace. Command check on the choir. They're loving it. Now the vassal mechanic's being targeted.
11 and 5, 16.
Yep, so it hits it on a 16.
Armor 15,
Cover
so
15.
Two,
oh, that would have been that would have been a good roll. That was a 19.
Sorry, armor 15. Yep. So drop that. So 1 point.
So 1 point against the mechanic. Bring it down to four boxes. Can you see through the target through the?
Yeah,
no, the objective.
I can see through my own guy.
Oh, okay.
They have ranged attacks.
Oh, okay. I didn't realize you had ranked attacks, so ranked attacks allows you to shoot through your own guys. Yep, that's 11, so no martyr. Still got, looks like, four guys that can still shoot. All three? One in the front. Oh, yeah, I missed that dice. It's hiding it behind, so three guys still left. We're going to shoot at the devout.
Cool.
First one back is out. First hits on the first.
18, 8, like a ship. 16 plus 2, yeah. So dice off 8.
Dice off 8.
That's beyond spare.
Because it's Bubba, the way Bubba rolls dice, that's why. 4 to the 8.
Hits.
So it hits. So the so Bubba is moving. If it wasn't apparent already, Bubba is moving the Victor. Yeah, I. Alex was just explaining how he dynamically posed his model, which I completely agree with. Shoulder lining up the shoulders is just sucks when it looks like their heads facing the wrong direction. Power attacking, and Uncle Joe is dead again. Following Canadian rules. So he's attacking the avatar.
Hits. On a 2. Strength 18. 12. I win. Throwing him out the record.
Oh, he's doing a, is it two-handed throw?
Yeah, yeah.
Two-handed throw at the...
I win anyway.
Yeah.
Strength 18.
Yeah. 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 There was no way to lose that roll.
Throwing at the record. Yeah.
Throwing it at the reckoner.
Yes.
So the both models are now knocked down.
So they're fighting. Suck it. Yep.
So Eliven, apparently, according to Bubba, can suck it. It's activating Silas. Just going to scamper out of the way around that objective, or oh, way back. And a Holtar activating. Going to shoot at the Reckoner. So put harm on the or Lillian's Kiss. She gives him plus 2 to damage rolls.
Hold
hits with a 4. Dice off 5, so nothing on the first shot. Hits with boxcars. Better to hit on that than damage on that. 1 to the 6. The only remaining Doom Reaver.
He's
going to charge the avatar.
Pass your melee summon your record. but I don't leave, like, you know, I don't leave my line of sight.
So he's in the back arc, but
auto-hitting POW 13, ignoring the shield.
Auto-hitting POW 13, ignoring the shield.
Because of
the
back arc.
Yeah, because of the back arc.
So armor 19. So dice off 6.
Dice off 6.
6 to the 4.
6 to the 4 on the avatar.
Mediocre bears. Front charge.
So the Great Bears are charging?
Actually, yeah. I'm not sure.
And they're charging Avatar. Was the other one charging the Reckoner?
Nope, Avatar. They have 360.
Okay. Okay.
He charged the Reckoner. He charged the Avatar.
Okay, gotcha. So two on the Avatar,
so
one on the
Avatar
Reckoner.
First backswing.
Avatar, backswing.
POW 12 Weapon Master.
POW 12 Weapon Master.
Oh, that was stupid.
21 on the shield?
Yeah. So dice off 9.
Dice off 9. On 4 dice.
Not bad. 3. Okay, I choose POW.
Three to the 1. Bubba's calling that one out.
Second attack.
Second attack.
Off 9 will be 4.
4 to the 1.
The guy who's in the avatar's backswing. Yep. Dice off 7.
Dice off 7 on the other.
It's 2. Dice off nine. My bad.
Okay, there we go.
Because now you got the shield. Sweet.
The shield is now out.
Second attack. Yeah. So you're down to 19. Yeah. So I'm still going.
So he's got 10 boxes left. Bubba's trying to figure out what he wants to do.
It's okay, I'm only going to generate one
box. Yes, the avatar will.
I'm going to do it on the Reckoner.
Yep. So he's going to do his auto hitting on the Reckoner.
So dice off 5.
Dice off 5, three. So it's 3. Ooh, nothing, not much on
to
the Reckoner.
Third to the 4. Great Bear, the charge the Reckoner, backswing.
Backswing on the charging Great Bear into the Reckoner.
Dice off 5.
Dice off 5. Ooh, that one's a good...
13.
That one's going to hurt. 13 to the 4.
Second attack.
And second attack on that Great Bear.
Just 8. Yep.
8 to the 1. How many boxes he left to?
7
boxes left on the Reckoner. Ruin is going to charge. So abomination check on his own unit. 9.
Joe.
Narrowly miss failing a check there.
Auto hitting straight dice. 8 points. Line attack. Straight dice.
Oh, he's attacking the objective. Jeff is down to 1. So Vlad is moving over 7 inches, checking kill box. I guess technically you're checking command or your control.
You check kill box and
okay. And clocks back to Alex.
I have 9 minutes and 7 seconds. Alex has 16 minutes.
So 9 minutes and 7 seconds on Bubba's clock. There's 16 left on Alex's. So Avatar gets 3 focus. Better than a kick in the teeth.
Okay. Can you now keep the record for any bits?
Nope.
Actually, the Avatar can, because opposite strike. That's very
sweet. Yep, they're...
Yeah, if you had free implies to get those, too good.
Yeah,
precision strike and the plus
pal,
two.
Pal 15, mat 11, pal 15, weapon masters, and you give them hand of face.
Oh, God.
And you're just like, we'll do dice.
Yeah.
It's almost like you're playing 40K.
It's like when you play...
Mm-hmm.
Or a Rust with Great Bears, but I think 5 days.
Wow, that's ridiculous.
And the Great Bears are Path 15 on Masters with Butcher.
Oh, jeez.
So Path 15.
So why am I getting them for Spencer again? Can you tell me why I'm setting myself up for that disaster?
Next trolls. Check my control area and trolls are set. I'm not done off.
That cough was brought to you by the Four New Gamers podcast, where I edit that stuff out normally. Alex is contemplating what his move is going to be. Alex is trying to piece out what he's going to do this turn. Alex still contemplating. But does Harvey have any offensive spells? Ooh, but what's range?
Range is
yeah,
but minus one pow.
Range 8 actually.
Minus one pow for every inch.
Okay.
Target something 8 inches away, it's pow 12.
Mm-hmm.
And if it deviates 4 inches forwards. I thought it was a return control.
Harvey's going to keep all 10 of the focus.
The devote is going to activate and the devote's going to walk.
Devote's going to activate and walk. Just basically block the victor. A noble thing to do.
Okay, the outs are...
So just verifying the defense of the Great Bears, which is 13. Charge the Great Bear. Going within half inch melee. He's a 5 on 2 dice. Dice off two. Takes out the bear.
Is going to activate and
so he's activating the choir. Intentionally building suspense. 6 inches of a battle of the reckoner.
The vassal's going to activate. He's going to walk over around the wall, face to face with the reckoner. That's over here.
Can
he's going to ancillary attack.
So
and I'm going to ancillary attack.
Do an ancillary attack after walking up to the. The vassal's up, we're backing up to the reckoner, doing a scenery attack against the.
You guys are both in range.
The
Draper's
up 360.
Draper's up 360, so I can walk potentially back to under one way here.
Zavatar's not down, but you can spend a focus to stand on.
Yeah, and then
you have to do that before we go.
Oh, it's not turn there.
It's during the main, so
I thought it was turn.
No, but it
should be.
So the avatar is standing?
Totally. Yeah, it's during the event. So, okay.
So, enlivening to hit this Doom Reaver.
Enlivening to hit Doom Reaver.
So, when the arm's out,
so you have one less die
to hit and damage. Or
no.
Just okay.
So, which one did you battle?
Battle him.
So, he's not 8.
Yeah,
so he's 5. So, just hit
the Doom Reaver.
Ooh, misses. He did a 5 on one die.
Same thing.
Gets a 6.
Darn it.
Okay, the avatar is going to activate and he's going to walk 5 inches. But stay real. I guess I can check.
You can check.
Oh, so. Stay really.
He's moving the avatar in such a way where he is staying within the melee range of both of them, because they have the Great Bears have 360. Up to the flag, but staying within melee.
Okay, hitting against the Great Bears.
Fives on the, to the Great Bears.
So swing with my sword,
sword against the first one.
It's
a 4, so that misses.
No shield.
So spend a focus to buy an attack, buy and boost. So getting a 5 on 2 dice, gets it with an 11. Tough check, fails.
You're going to fire. Because he blows up.
Checking to see if he, because he's hit by the avatar, if the flame effect is affects his own model, which it does not. Oh, kill boxes from the sides as well? Oh, I did not know that. So, going to move. Change of plans, not moving Harvey up quite as much as he thought he was originally going to.
Far enough ahead of all that, because
it
takes
a minute. He gives me 2 CPs.
Oh, yes.
And I just throw the ejection block.
So,
yeah, true.
Over here.
We're back up to 9.
3
people watching the stream. Remember, every Tuesday night at 7 o'clock, we're going to be playing games.
Cool.
Maybe not always be in the furnace room. Maybe over at Philbo Baggins' place.
Okay.
Yes, Phil, I'm volunteering your place for Home Machine.
Sweet. 5.5.
So
back. Goes up.
straight dice. So he gets the 5, fails the tough check, the remaining Great Bear. So how much do you have left on your clock? 4 minutes and 56 seconds left on Alex's clock. Bubba, what are you at? 9 minutes on Bubba's. This is the top of 5. So what are the control points? Like, is there any no control points yet? Because he has yet to destroy that one objective. Hand of Fates being upkeeped. So this just in, Corey is indicating that Nathan and Corey had a game. Waiting with bated breath to see what happened in that game. So Bubba's giving 3 to the Conquest. Conquest or the Victor? And 1 to Rune. So Bubba is cheating by changing the model in the middle of the game. So forfeits to Alex. So Bubba's activating Ionon Holt. Ah, this just in. Corey was able to beat Nathan. So now Corey is in Tier 3, and Nathan is dropping down to Tier 4. Holt's shooting. With a rat 10. Dice off 5, so nothing. Second shot hits on an 8. 6 to 3. Holt doesn't quite come through. Doesn't provide the clutch play when needed. Joe is activating. He's going to do boosted attack rolls. He's going to shoot at the Reckoner. Hits with a solid big number. So nothing on the Reckoner. Wintergard is rifle core is activating. Apparently, there was a casualty at the game where Corey broke his ruin. Wow, that is a 22. That is one very dead Reckoner. Bubba's contemplating next move.
Super
so like, oh god. No. So shooting the objective. And not quite hitting the Have a good night's sleep. That was my daughter going to bed.
I'm not going to bed yet.
Well, she's not going to bed yet, apparently. I'll keep everyone updated on that.
It's just to hear the mask.
Okay, we'll go up and hear your mask.
It was just Jamie.
I don't know why.
Silas
is going to run.
So Silas is running. I'd like to see Silas run in and charge Harbinger. Be the win of the game. Okay, so Bubba is muttering to himself about something. So Bubba is charging his Victor. So getting up to the avatar just within reach range. We'll be taking a free strike from the... No, he won't take a free strike? No, you're still within the...
He's facing that way, so he's in my... Or he's... I'm in his
melee. Oh, okay. So, no free strike.
Avatar
interesting.
Yeah. It's,
I believe the Avatar is about to get its ass handed to himself.
6 points. Okay, so...
6 points to the...
Second initial.
Boosting the second initial hit.
I don't have melee. It's plus 3, right? Hit.
And so that takes out the avatar. I don't think it matters at this point, does it? We have Bubba's got tons of them. So our friend in our friend in Greece just wants you to charge Harvey so he can go to bed. No, we're gonna draw this out. You told us you're staying until the end. We're gonna make this go to clock. Vlad is running. Vlad's going in the forest, but still staying within the kill box. How much time left on your clock, Bubba?
3:34.
3 minutes and 34 seconds?
Alex has 5 minutes.
Alex has 5 minutes. Bottom of the fifth. And Bubba is at 2 control points for destroying the...
objective and ruins controlling it.
In ruins controlling it, gotcha.
Yeah. There's no way I can do it? No. I can maybe score less.
If you destroy the objective...
And then, like, the devote runs and stops me from scoring this turn. Ruben eats him.
Yeah.
And then Vlad runs. Yeah. That, like, you also, like, you'd have to clear them as well.
Yeah, exactly.
So just working through the scenarios here, and it looks like there is...
Sorry, you have half on it. Like, can she be charged? So she can be charged.
Trying to figure out where, how we can not lose on scenario.
She gets to,
at
like,
this point, it looks like.
That's why I was like, I gotta run and freaking.
So Harvey would have to run, take out a few models, and to get there. Doesn't look like that's gonna happen. And because right now, next turn, Bubba will get 2 points at the end of this turn.
I tried to do it to just.
1 point? Oh yeah, one point. Control. 1 point for Rune, and then so beginning of turn, go to three in his turn, and then go. Vlad will run up.
Yeah, I tried
on his turn and dominate.
I'm not in, you're not in my turn. No, you're past. Yeah. So even if I run away and contest that, that's what I mean. Ruin's just like, you're dead. Yeah. So you don't start this turn. But then you,
yeah, there's
three on my turn.
Yeah, there's.
I only do ruins activation. I do nothing else.
Yeah.
I go to three, and it's like, you get something else there, and flat. And ruin will just eat whatever, gets there.
Oh, yeah.
Good. Yeah,
yep. It's calling it because there's no way not to for Bubba to win on scenario.
Or assassination. Like,
or assassination.
Harvey walks over the wall.
Yeah, she's dead.
She's dead to a Victor. And, like, he's not going to kill Victor. No. He still has 31 boxes. Harvey's going to kill
him. Yeah, there's just not enough. Even with her nasty spell.
I don't know. She'll just, like, auto hit, leap out, like, with all her hits. Cataclysm. Boosted Cataclysms at straight dice.
Yeah.
That's the best he can do. Yeah. And then he has no focus.
Was Cataclysm is 8?
Like cost 4.
It costs 4. Okay, so
it's auto hitting. And then he boosts damage.
Yeah.
So he does 22 damage.
You have 36 left.
I have 30.
Yeah. Okay.
What was the guy's...
So the question was, I'll scroll...
Greek guy, don't leave.
Yeah, don't leave yet. We've got the question. Oh, we're up to 11, so I don't understand how we're at the end of the game and we're up to 11.
I told more people
so,
the group I forgot to tell that I was playing.
Dolus87, who is our friend in Greece, can I be educated as the units Bubba chose to play with Vlad 2? Seems like the only good feat target were the Doom Reavers. What if they got shot or jammed? How come no Uleons or Outriders instead of the Woodregard Rifle Corps?
Okay. So, in this particular list...
Let me turn the mic up a little bit here, too, as well. Okay, go ahead.
In this particular list, the Doom Reavers were the only target. But I didn't really care about my feet. Like, if one Doom Reaver lived and got feeded on, cool. Like, I just didn't care. No Uleons, because that's the unit I forgot.
Yeah.
They were in the list. And then on the drive here, I was like, I forgot them. So I swapped. The Uhlans were in, so I took out the Uhlans and put in the Great Bears and Fingers.
Okay.
So it's a straight swap, 11 points. And I wanted to play Assault Commandos instead of Ruin.
Okay.
Hot swap, Hand of Fate between Assault Commandos and Rifle Corps. The rifle corps were always in the list.
Okay.
But I don't own assault rifles, and I'm trying to find some this week. But like, nobody owns them because they're garbage. But they're really good with Vlad with Animate because they have 3-inch short attacks. So that I just smash guys. But the reason for rifle corps is they're insane with Vlad. Like, Vlad makes everything good.
Yeah.
He's a turret polisher with Handfeat.
Yeah, Handfeat does a lot.
But rifle corps, because they're so long range, they can just sit back and be totally safe.
They're range 14, right?
Range 14, top 10. And, like, with Joe, so they're boosted to hit. Because they can stay so far back, Joe doesn't have to be tough like a winner or a Death Star.
Mm-hmm.
So they just sit back.
And scalpel out when
you just, like, shoot your front line. If you jam my troopers with, like, errands or zealots or something, I'm like, I'll just aim and shoot you. I go to Rat 7, boosted to hit from Joe with Hand of Fate.
Yeah.
Like, I'm going to hit death, like, 19 or 20 on average.
Wow.
So, like, I don't care if you're jamming at death 16. I'm just like, I don't care. Like, so it's really good. Victory for this too.
So Daryl Gonzalez just said hello.
Daryl, hey, Daryl. Yeah, that's the guys I wanted to tell to come watch.
Okay.
Daryl and I were talking a lot lately. What is it?
Hi, guys.
Oh, hey, Daryl. Sorry you came at the end of the game.
Just as we're wrapping it up.
Yeah. Well, I don't want a scenario. You had to feed that turn.
Yeah.
And that was my plan. I was like, dude, you're going to feed the turn at war. You're going to feed Asha back up. Forget this Zelda this week. But I actually
don't think about it. No, I was really. Okay, not counting on drills, but I was like.
Yeah, gather those
first.
It could have done a little bit, right? Well, setting stuff on fire would have made a big difference.
And then try to position to come around away from them and then have enlivens to be ready to come back at you with an avatar.
Yeah.
And then an avatar and a. Like a salting reckoner.
Yeah, I thought the throw was pretty cute.
Yeah, the throw was not. Didn't. I mean, even if I could think of that, I don't know.
I was like, double and lab, how do I get around this?
Yeah.
So I think one of the questions just from Daryl was how many of the rifle corps are still alive. I think they all are. Yeah. Yeah, you didn't really take. I mean, you took out the Great Bears and the Doom Reavers. That's really the only thing they were taking off the table.
Yeah,
correct. That's all they
had. Okay.
Which would have been Ulans, which all would have died.
And Daryl, just so you know, it's not a conquest, it's a victory in this game. Well, I think we have to, it's getting about that time, so I just want to thank both Bubba and Alex for coming down and everyone for watching. Stay tuned for next week. Well, as soon as we know who's playing, we'll post it. And again, you can watch this on YouTube probably sometime either today, later on today or first thing tomorrow. I don't bother editing it, so I do all this stuff now, it's just I just throw it on up. At least I have that little opening thing to make it look good. So, again, follow the Four New Gamers podcast, where a number of our local players are on that. Also follow, I don't know, who do you want people to follow, Bubba?
At Refugee on Twitter.
At Refugee on Twitter.
R-E-F-Y-O-U-G-E-E.
There we go. And good night to our friend in Greece. Thanks for joining us.
Jeez.
And thanks for watching, and stay tuned for next week. Take care, everyone.